All right, so I'm excited because today we're going to actually get into the meat, the core of what this whole video series is about, and that's actually being able to be a better musician, rapper, whatever it is. And it doesn't matter what genre it is. I think any genre is capable of using a lot of these things, including multis, which is what I'm going to be covering today. And the reason I chose to do multis is because the next video is going to be on flow, and I really want to make sure that people that are listening know what to listen for. Otherwise, I think the flow video could possibly be more harmful than helpful. So we're going to focus on multis and just, you know, which, you know, is a short term for multisyllabic rhyming. And there are definitely non-rap songs that incorporate this, but it's very rare to hear it from any genre other than rap. And this is kind of one of the first things that really made me fall in love with rap as a genre. So this is, we're just going to jump into it. You know, the idea is very simple, but it's that you have, you know, you have one regular rhyme and then new, true. But then, you know, you can append on another rhyme. So a blue, you know, chip, new whip, two crip, and then blue, you know, and this is, and this is just an example of the lyricism, and I'm not claiming that I'm a gangster, but you would take, you know, an entire phrase where you have two different rhymes, and essentially you can say, okay, and we'll start with here, just say, I'm a true Crip. I blew clips into his brain and walked away with a new whip and a blue chip. So now you have two syllable rhymes going on where you have blue chip, new whip, true Crip, blue clips, and they're all together. And you're going to see this from a lot of different rappers, and that's kind of what I'm going to be covering today. It's just kind of pointing that out into some songs. Now, in this example, we only have two syllables, but you can increase that to three, four, five syllables. Now, in that example, you saw two syllable multis with perfect rhyming. But when you have more syllables, three, four, five syllables, you don't really want to constrain yourself to the point where you can only use perfect rhyming, because then you're really going to limit your lyrical content, the things you are allowed to say. Because, you know, once you, you know, have a perfect rhyme and then, you know, everything has to rhyme exactly, like, for example, art, part, and start, you have a very limited vocabulary that you're allowed to pick from. And then when you have, you know, one after another, after another, after another, you really, you know, start limiting all your options. So often what you'll see in hip-hop is that people do slant rhyming. And this is an actual example from J. Cole's Is She Gon' Pop. And I'm just going to read the whole thing so you can kind of hear how it sounds rather than, you know, looking at it directly word by word and seeing whether or not everything rhymes perfectly. So he has the words art of seduction, part of production, start off with something, father was hustling. So father is meant to rhyme with these three here, and you know, it has a similar sound to it. It's kind of an assonance of anything, but father, start off, part of, art of. So these are what I would call indefinite rhymes, because these definitely have a sound to them, right? Art, part, start, fa, it all has an intended sound. But of off there. In here, you have seduction, production, with something, was, duck. This is definitely a sound. This is a sound. These two are what I would call indefinite. So this is just a term I made up. And basically, I'm just saying that it doesn't necessarily have, it could be really any rhyme or any word to an extent. Like, you know, if I had cow, and I would just to put a start cow with something. You know, it's just like, it can be just about anything depending on how you emphasize it. But the sound you're kind of getting out of it is kind of a short I sound. So something like hit with this. So you're kind of getting that, you know, sound. It doesn't really have, you know, as long as you're not emphasizing the way that it sounds, you can put just about anything here. So you have art of seduction, which is all just, you know, one full rhyme, production, seduction and production rhyme. But then when you have here, you have with something. So with something. And that's where you get that extra indefinite rhyme with something, which, you know, if you were to actually pronounce production, it wouldn't rhyme with seduction. So that's also going to be an indefinite sound because you have production. It just sounds more like an I, you know, short I sound. And then here you have was. Was is also kind of a short I sound. So was hustling. So hopefully that doesn't confuse you more than it helps you. Really, what you should think of is everything as a phrase. You know, you're rhyming the whole phrase, not just one word. Art of seduction. What rhymes with art of seduction? Art of seduction. Ottoman, like Ottoman something. Call them in bluffing. You know, things that just, you know, have that same general sound to it. So here you have art of seduction, part of production, start off with something, father was hustling. And we'll look at some actual examples here to hopefully give you a better idea of how everything is used in practice. All right, so here is an example from Fabulous in his song Can't Let You Go. And I'm not saying this is the best example. It's actually a good example to show you that not everything is, number one, not everything is a perfect rhyme. And number two, you'll see a lot of redundancy sometimes. People will use the same rhymes over and over. And I'll show you what I mean. Here, if you ever actually listen to the song, you can hear that that he puts a little bit of an emphasis on the words no, show, and go. So he goes, you know my situation. And sometimes I know you get impatient, but you don't put on a show to get ovations, take it to court, and go through litigations. So he has no, which, you know, is the same word, obviously, both rhyming. He also has show and go rhyming. And then here you have get impatient rhyming with situation, get ovation, but he doesn't put that extra emphasis on the O that would make it sound like get ovations. He says get ovations. And then here, litigation. So he's rhyming litigation, get ovation, and get impatient with situation. And these are all four-syllable. This is situation, four-syllable rhymes here, but then he has on these extra two syllables. So overall, that is a six-syllable rhyme. And you can keep looking at a couple other bars here. Respect your gangsta. This is supposed to be, I'm just going to write in yeah, because that's not you. I respect your gangsta, but I respect, spect rhymes with neck. So you have spect your gangsta, neck to thank you. So gang rhymes with thank, and then sta is a slant rhyme on yeah, you. And then pinch hitter, bench with her. So we have pinch hit her, bench with her. And then you can keep on looking. There are definitely more throughout this whole song. And these are all definitely done intentionally. You hear this from rappers all the time in, you know, thousands of songs. Here's another song from Drake and his song Duppy, which was a diss to Pusha T, and a lot of people said he lost that battle. I'm actually one of the few people that probably think he won that, but you know, that's irrelevant. That's a personal opinion. I don't expect people to agree with it, but I just wanted to point a couple things out. So I've done things for him I thought he never would need. So you have never would need, and this is two syllables, get it. So never get it from me, and then let him repeat. So you have never get it, let him, dead, asleep, pen to the sheets, enemies eat. That's four syllables there. Pen to the sheet, four syllables. So all these are four syllables. This is not a rhyme. This is a head over heats, denim or Steve, head in the beam, jealousy breeds. So all of these are four syllables. And if you, you know, actually listen to the way he delivers it, you can tell it's very intentional. He goes, never would need, get it from me, let him repeat, dead him asleep, pen to the sheets, enemies eat, head over heats, denim or Steve, head in the beam, jealousy breeds. So you can see that these are all four syllable rhymes, and they go on for quite a while here. Here you even keep going, album mode, talent goes. So album rhymes with talent, mode, and goes. Challenge those. Album, talent, challenge, Alamo. So all of these are also three-syllable rhymes. Album mode, talent goes, challenge those, and Alamo. And you'll see examples of this from pretty much every artist. For example, Eminem. This song, he literally did three verses, all of them off of the same multi. Sky is falling, so four syllables. So here he has sky. That rhymes with I am Martian, I involved, he used I a lot. So sky has fallen, I am Martian, I involved in, the way that people enter these lines into Genius, they're not meant to be the actual line length that, I imagine that when Eminem wrote it on paper, he did not have this random break in here, he would not have wanted that. But anyway, so defiant often, so phi rhymes with sky, I, phi, at my mom, pliant, shy and awkward. So in all of these, and let me just change the color here. So we have fallen, Martian, involved in, often, awkward. This one he changes up. I'll look at that in a second. Try and solve them. But if you just look at it, we have sky is falling, am I a Martian, I involved in, defiant often, shy and awkward. Here he you know, kind of just used the end of a word to add in the rhyme. And that's perfectly acceptable. And that's perfectly acceptable, so it's good to know that you can do that. But here you just have shy and awkward, try and solve them, drive talking, hiding often, trying not to, crying and sobbing. He added an extra syllable in there. I ain't talking. Flying off the, so flying off at is actually part of this whole rhyme here. Flying off at the handle at my mom, no dad, so I am non-com. I think this was meant to be a rhyme. I am non-com is part of the whole rhyme scheme that he has going. I am non-compliant at home. At school, I'm just shy and awkward, and I don't need no goddamn psychologist, which kind of rhymes but then there's this extra syllable. Trying to diagnose why I have all these is also part of the rhyme here. So you keep seeing this pattern of four syllables. I have all these, defiant often, I involved in, sky is falling, flying off at, I am non-com, shy and awkward, psychola, you know, it's a little bit different there. You can have little twist on things depending on how it sounds, especially with the rhythm and the flow and the beat. Here you have lion problems, so underlying problems. I'm outside chalking up, and you can literally go through the whole song and listen, but you know, he has probably, you know, at least 50 of these rhymes off of the same syllable all throughout the song. And really the best thing to do is to actually go out and listen to rappers that are considered real lyricists, like especially older rappers like Nas and Jay-Z. Biggie didn't really have a whole lot of multis. He's actually an exception. So his style was very interesting. I'm actually a huge fan of Biggie, even though he did not incorporate a lot of multis. He had like a lot of internal rhymes, and we'll talk about that later. But there are a lot of like... Big Pun is definitely one. In fact, I want to bring up some Big Pun lyrics right now. All right, so here's some examples from Big Pun. And this is actually really good if I were to talk about rhyme schemes. And I might bring it back up later. Let's just go ahead and focus on the multis for now. So we have murderous rap. So that's murderous rap. That's four syllables right there. And then we have this is another four syllables that rhymes with that, which is verbal attack. So we have verbal attack. So murderous rap, verbal attack. And then he switches it up. He goes to actual fact. So that's three syllables, actually four syllables, actual fact. Then he goes with graphical stats. So actual rhymes with graphical, fact rhymes with stats. Half of you lack, so half of you rhymes with graphical, actual, and then lack. Magical, graphical, actual, dap. So magical dap of tragical rap tackles your back and shackles and laughs at you. Mathematical madness. So he adds a little bit there. Mathematical mad. And then he kind of switches up into a different rhyme. So tackles your back and then shackles and laughs. So madness I'm on. Savage to strong. Marriage and bond of havoc and song. Massacres on. As if Picasso laced you, and then he starts moving into another. So you can see more examples, and there's really nothing that can illustrate multis better than, I think, listening to the actual songs and really listening to how they sound when they rhyme, because, you know, it just has a different element to it that I think, you know, gets underappreciated, especially if you don't know what you're listening for. But it just sounds really cool when you're like, actual fact, tactical tracks match perfectly with graphical stats. Half of you lack the magical dap of tragical rap that tackles your back and shackles and laughs at you. So definitely go out there and listen to a lot of those old school 90s, 2000s rappers. Anybody who is really considered a lyricist should, you know, have at least a fair amount of multis. And it's something I think everybody should know how to do, regardless of what genre you're in, because I think it adds another component to your rhyming. And especially in hip-hop, it does help in your flow. And we'll talk about that, how flow and rhyme schemes all work, when we move on to the next couple videos. But for now, I think that's everything I wanted to cover.